Muhammad Amin Noor. He says, my mother passed away 40 days ago. I wanted to go to the burial grounds and recite Surah Yasin, and my father said not to go. Who is right, me or my father? First of all, may Allah have mercy on your mother. May Allah make her grave a garden of paradise. Secondly, before answering your question, if it is something between me and my father, even if it is a legal question, I wouldn't say who's right, me or my father. I would say which opinion is right. And is it true that I'm not supposed to go to the graveyard? Because, you know, your father is not a rival. He's not a competitor. He is not, you know, I understand that your intention is good. But we're also here to help one another to learn the proper way of presenting a question and pay the due respect to our parents. And guess what? Your father is right anyway. So why is he right? We do not commemorate the death of no one. And obviously, there was no death that hurt the Muslim and it affected them so much and it saddened them more than the death of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Just imagine when Umar ibn Khattab, may Allah be pleased with him, who was a very wise man, very powerful man, he almost lost his mind. And he went out threatening those who would say the Prophet has died that he will chop off his head. It was only when Abu Bakr Siddiq returned and he looked at the Prophet ﷺ and he was certain that he passed away. Umar ibn Khattab was basically saying that he went for a meeting with his Lord and he will come back like Prophet Moses. He couldn't imagine that he would miss Prophet Muhammad ﷺ. It was only when Abu Bakr Siddiq calmed him down and said, وَمَا مُحَمَّدٌ إِلَّا رَسُولٌ قَدْ خَلَتْ مِنْ قَبْلِهِ الرُّسُلُ أَفَإِنْ مَاتَ أَوْ قُتِلَ انْقَلَبْتُمْ عَلَىٰ أَعْقَابِكُمْ. When Abu Bakr Siddiq recited this ayah upon Umar ibn Khattab, which means that Muhammad is not but a messenger whom many messengers before have come and they left, they died. So whether he is killed, whether he dies, or whether he is killed, that you would return back to your heels or go back over your heels, yani would you abstain, would you convert from the deen? Is your Islam linked to the presence of Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam? Did you only accept Islam for Muhammad or for Allah? So, وَمَنْ يَنْقَلِبْ عَلَىٰ عَقِبَيْهِ فَلَنْ يَضُرَّ اللَّهَ شَيْئًا. So when Umar ibn Khattab heard Abu Bakr al-Siddiq reciting this ayah, said, Subhanallah, it's like I've never heard it before. He knows the ayah, but he was overwhelmed with the catastrophe of the death of Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Why am I saying this? I'm saying this because to show you, to remind you how much the Sahaba, may Allah be pleased with them, loved Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Urwa ibn Mas'ud said when he was deployed by the Meccans to negotiate the treaty of when the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam came to perform Umrah on the sixth year and they didn't allow him. So he narrated his experience, how he saw the companions loving, respecting, and revering their Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So he went to the Mecca and said, by Allah, I visited Kisra wa Qaisar. I visited these Persian emperors and Roman emperors and this and that. I have never seen any people who loved, revered, and respected their leader as much as Ashabu Muhammad loved Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam. Just imagine that if he were to make wudu, not a single drop of water would fall from his wudu. Some Sahabi would pick it up with the water over his face. All the Sahaba used to love the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam more than they loved their own selves and family members. When he died, they submitted to the will of Allah. They offered the funeral prayer and they buried the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They did not take the day of his death a day of celebration. They did not gather a week later to commemorate his death. They did not gather 40 days later to commemorate his death. They did not gather annually to make Khatmul Quran so that they will send each one make Khatmul Quran once and give it to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wasallam. They did not ask one another to make Umrah or Hajj on behalf of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam. So basically all of that is categorized as an innovation. So can you visit the graveyard to visit your mom, to make dua for her any time, day or night? But when you deliberately think that on the 40s I have to visit or on the Eid day because of this or that, that's an innovation. Assalamu alaikum. Sister Medina from Ethiopia, assalamu alaikum.
How are you, Sheikh?
I'm fine. Thank you for asking, Sister Medina. I hope you're doing well as well.
How is your mom?